Hello everyone, welcome to Falcon Informatic. In this video, I am going to show how to generate your OTP with the help of Python. For that, we will use one library called random. The main purpose of using this library is it will generate random numbers we mentioned here. So with the help of this library, we can generate our own OTP number. Now I am going to explain this code. In the first line, I am importing the main required library called random. After importing that, what I am going to do is I am going to get input from the user. The reason why I am getting input from user is it will ask the user to enter the length of the OTP. So here, if I am entering the digit as 4, means it will generate a 4-digit OTP. Likewise, if I am entering 6, means it will generate a 6-digit OTP number. So for that purpose only, here I am getting input from user. So you can see, to get input from user, we will use this syntax called input, and inside that I am using enter the length of the OTP, and I am storing that integer value in this variable user pass. After that, what I am going to do is, here I am creating one list, and inside the list you can see I entered all the possible digit to generate OTP. So we are going to create OTP from 0 to 9 numbers. With the help of these numbers only, we are going to generate OTP. So I mentioned all the 10 digits here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 in this list. And after that, here I am creating one empty string called OTP. After creating that empty string, what I am going to do is I am creating one for loop here. I will explain what is the reason behind this for loop. So in for loop, we are using a range function. What is the purpose of this range function is, we are giving 6 inside this range function, means the loop will iterate 6 times. Likewise, if you are giving 4, means inside this range function, the loop will iterate 4 times. For example, 0, 1, 2, 3. So likewise, it iterates 4 times. So for that purpose only, we are using a range function here. And I will show one example here. If I am entering the digit as 4, means here, the user pass is replaced by 4. So the loop will iterate 4 times. That is the main use of range function here. And inside the for loop, you can see here, guest letter is equal to password randint 0,9. What is the exact meaning for this line is, the Python will try to pick one random digit from this list. For example, in the first iteration, if it picks 1, means it will pick only one digit from this list for every iteration. So in the first iteration, if it picks 1, means it will store that 1 in this guest letter. Okay, so after storing that here, in the next line, it will be replaced here in guest letter. It will be replaced here as 1. And here there is one variable called OTP. Initially it will be empty, so only 1 will be stored in this OTP. So here in OTP variable, the string 1 is stored in the first iteration. And in the next iteration, what will happen is, again the Python will try to pick one random digit from these numbers. So for example, in the next iteration, if it picks 2, means what will happen is, here it will be replaced by 2. And here in OTP, we already in last iteration we stored 1 in this OTP, so here it will be replaced as 1. So what will happen is, in the end of the second iteration is, here 2 and here 1, both are combined, and the 21 is stored in this OTP. So likewise, in next iteration, again it will try to pick that digit from this list. For example, if it picks 3, means what will happen is, it will store that 3 in guest letter. In the next line, here what will happen is, here it will be replaced by 3, and here it will be replaced by 21, because in the end of second iteration, the OTP value is 21. So here it will be replaced as 21. And after the end of the third iteration, what will happen is, the output 3, 2, 1 will be stored in this OTP as a string. Okay. So likewise, it will generate OTP. After completing the fourth iteration, what will happen is it will completely create one 4-digit OTP number. We will print that. After printing that OTP number, here again I am also printing the OTP is that OTP generated by Python. I will show the output, then you will understand it clearly. So you can see here in the first, it will ask the length of the OTP. So if I am giving the length of the OTP is 4 means it will generate 4-digit random OTP number. And you can see one more thing also, it won't create the same OTP number again and again. I will show that. So if I am running this program again, means I am giving digit as 4 means, so you can see both the OTPs are different. So likewise, it will generate random OTP. So this is the concept behind how the OTPs are generated using Python. If you have any doubts or any queries, means please let me know in comment section. I will clear that. Thanks for watching. Keep supporting us. Thank you.